Hi there. This presentation is going to give a very brief and probably inadequate, but introductory at least, presentation of theories of fertility. And we'll begin with the theory of multiphasic demographic response, which was offered by Kingsley Davis way back in the 60s. And essentially, this was a theory that considered how different res societies responded to the condition of having very high fertility levels, which resulted in the 50s, the 40s, 50s, and 60s as countries were modernizing. Some turned to birth control, some leaned more heavily on the principle of abstention, some turned to economic modernization, and urbanization would follow with that, and generally, come up with avoidance of relative deprivation strategies. Those include celibacy, waiting to get married, using contraception within marriage, also increasing rates of abortion or sterilization, and also migration as a response, both internal rural urban migration and external international migration. The theory of intermediate variables gets right down to the immediate causes of fertility. Those include intercourse, conception, and gestation. So the focus is cultural. It's on norms that shape thinking and behaviors around those three things. So focusing on things that would influence age of entry into sexual intercourse, celibacy, time spent outside unions, abstinence within marriage, frequency within marriage, and then in terms of conception, looking at both sterilization and contraception. And then for gestation, the topic of abortion, of course, very controversial. Different cultures have different takes on that, but that's going to impact fertility levels. So these are all the immediate or intermediate variables that go between culture and actual fertility outcomes. It's another family of fertility theories that we might just simply refer to as economic theories because they tend to reduce fertility outcomes to economic causes, such as Becker's quality of children theory, where people have to consider the opportunity costs of having children. And of course, if they think it's too expensive, are less likely to have children. And if they think it's worthwhile economically, they'll go for it. Easterlin uses a relative income argument to look at the ability to provide for children. It's not just simply the opportunity cost, but the ability to provide for them. Coale offers a cultural theory that more or less critiques the economic theories. He says economic causes are not central and points back to the value and custom role of culture in general, values, beliefs, and norms. But also points to the importance of the autonomy of women and the way that results in different fertility outcomes. The last family of theories would be the social structural theories, which are what we might call macro sociological. The first of those is modernization theory, which not surprisingly focuses on the role of modernization, but that more or less implies industrialization. And that means a transformation of the economy, the structure of occupations, the shift from agriculture to industry and service, and so forth. And what that brings with it culturally also is important in modernization theory, but also politically. And what tends to happen is as countries modernize, their fertility levels tend to decline. Similarly, Caldwell offers his wealth flow theory, which is a combination of structural and cultural theory. Perhaps more so than modernization, it incorporates values and looks at how education and values interact with structural opportunities in the economy and so forth in terms of advancement. And Caldwell points out that there was a shift in the wealth flow pattern once, particularly in agricultural societies, it flows from child to parent, whereas in industrial and post-industrial societies, it flows from parent to child, and therefore there's an economic incentive to reduce fertility. So these are the major theories, some of them more economically based, some of them more culturally based, some of them more macro-focused, the structural theories, and some of them combining elements of all. Thanks for watching.